Children, today we are going to do the advertisement, sale purchase of household goods and matrimonial. Let's see the slide. Now, under this household item, now there are certain points to remember. This type of advertisement is written by a person who wants to sell the household item because of transfer or purchase of a new item or any other reason. That means you want to sell your things which are there in the house. Household item means items which are there inside your house, and you, for any reason whatsoever, maybe you want to buy a new dining table and you want to replace the old one, or you want to buy a new fridge and you want to replace the old one, and then you want to sell it off. So then it will be coming under the category of household item. Now these three points remain the same. Advertisement to have heading, content and expression, because the marks are there for all these three things. So marks are allotted for all the three. Now there are certain value points. Now value points, as I told you, that if you know the value points, and then you can write the content on your own. If you remember that these things should be there, because when the examiner is checking your advertisement, they'll be looking out for these value points. If you have written these value points, then there's no doubt that you're going to get the full marks. So the first thing is that advertisement has to start with for sale or purchase word, or available or wanted. Okay, remember this. So you have to begin your advertisement with these words. Now you have to tell in your advertisement what is the type of household item, whether it's an electrical item, electronic item or furniture, what you want to sell. Maybe if people even sell their mattresses or so whatever it is, computer. So you have to mention what it is, and then product means also the same thing, and then brand means which brand, that it's a Philips, Sony, whatever brand is, model or the certain model number, or you can say the model and the year of manufacturing can be same also. Now product features. Now if it is a fridge, for example, then how big the fridge is, what is the liter or the capacity of the fridge, then is there any special facility, or there are certain fridge which have a kind of a ice making facility which fastens the ice making process. So is it having that? If those kinds of features you have to mention. And duration used, that means for how many years you have been using this product, when did you purchase it, or if the date of purchase and year of manufacturing will be the same. So even if you are missing this and you are writing this, you are going to get the marks. And even if you don't write both these two and you write year of manufacturing, then also you will get the marks. And then condition of item, whether it needs any repair or has it been repaired any time in the previous years when you were using it, and what is the expected price which you are expecting that when you sell the thing or when you buy, what is the expected range which you think that you will be able to buy the product. And contact address, if in case you are selling, then how will the people come to you? You should give your contact address, or you can even leave your email when the deal is finalized. Then at the end you can give them your contact address. There's no need for everyone to have your contact address, or you can even give your phone number. So these are the value points which you should remember while writing your advertisement of sale and purchase of household item. Now let's take an example of household item. You are moving to a new city as you have been transferred by your company and want to dispose of furniture, electrical and electronic goods. Draft an advertisement to be inserted in a local newspaper giving necessary details of the items. So as I told you, the heading should be there because you're going to get marks for the heading. So you write the heading household item for sale. Okay. Now, since you want to sell it off, no? So you're writing for sale. So now you will start with available, since the thing is with you. So you want to sell it. So you will write it available. Available for immediate sale, a 6-seater white color Italian leather sofa in excellent condition, center table with brass carving, teak wood showcase, 180-liter black color, 210 model Whirlpool fridge. See, I've given the model, year of manufacturing, everything. Philips, again the model, air fryer, 218 2018 model and one Philips Home Theater 2015 model at a very reasonable price. Contact Dipali Srivastava, phone number this, email this. So very simple, you these things you have in your house, you are seeing things around you. So whatever you have in your house, write the same thing. If it is electronic item, think of whatever you have in your house, write the same brand. And you can write any year of manufacturing which you feel like, what comes to your mind at that time, you can write it. So there's nothing to worry about. This can be easily answered if this type of question comes to you. Now let's look at the next one, what the next one is. Now, this is the case if you want to purchase the item. The previous one, you were selling the item. Now, you want to purchase the item. See, as I always do, I try to keep the content more or less same. Let us see how it works out. You are moving to a new city as you have been transferred by your company and want to purchase furniture, electrical and electronic goods in a new city. Draft an advertisement to be inserted in a local newspaper giving necessary details of the item. So, household items for sale. Previously, it was household items for sale, and this time it is for purchase. So, last time you were writing available, now you are writing wanted. So, wanted for immediate purchase. A 6-seater leather sofa, this remains same. Now, you can't, last time you had written it was white in color, Italian leather, but you can't write this, you can't demand as when you want to purchase. So, that because you are purchasing like this, it means that you are purchasing a second hand thing. So, you will write preferably white in good condition, preferably white in good condition. And center table, and you had written center table with brass carving, so you can't write that. So, center table with ethnic look, teak wood showcase, 180 liter fridge, air fryer. So you're not writing the brand of the fridge, you're not writing the brand of the air fryer as you had written in the previous one, because when you are when you want to purchase, you can't be sure that the person will be having the same brand which you want. And one home theater 2015, price needs to be reasonable. Contact Dipali Srivastava, phone number this and this. So one home theater. So everything remains the same. You can just delete this off because the model also will not be there, as you can't demand the model of anything whenever you want to purchase from any other person. So nothing will be there. So the items remain the same. Only what the changes wanted, and whenever you want something very specific, then you can write preferable. Otherwise, content remains the same. So this is how you can work it out. It's easy. Just you have to go through it 4 to 5 times. Keep going through it. Take out the printout of this from your my blog, and as and when you find time, see the go through the content, and then there's nothing. You can easily do it, and you can score full 5 marks in this. So now let's come to the next advertisement, which is about matrimonials. Matrimonial is related to marriage. So when you have something, matrimonial means marriage only. So when it marriage related. So when it is something about matrimonial, so that means either you want a bride or you want a bride groom. So you initially previous years, there used to be lot of one page used to be dedicated in the newspaper, which used to be of matrimonial alliances only. But now since the ambassador site which have come up, now it is not much of use, but since it's there in the syllabus, you can go through it as to how it has to be written. So first thing, as again and again I'm re-emphasizing, that three things: heading, content and expression. These are the 3 points on which the marks are being allotted. So what do you have to write for the matrimonial? So advertisement to start with, for bride wanted or groom wanted. So it has to be either you are wanting a bride or you are wanting a groom. So anything can be written depending upon who is giving the ad. Now then, whoever, whether it's a bride or a groom, you have to write what the height is, whether the person is wheatish complexion or fair complexion, what the age is, what is the educational qualification, is there any professional qualification, what is the job which the person is doing, how much salary person is getting, what caste. Since in India we follow this caste system, so the caste can be mentioned if the person is very specific about it, whereas nowadays the system of caste is not being followed so much. So even most of the people also do write that caste caste no bar. But if it is required by a person, it's no problem, because in India we still follow this. Marriages should be between the caste. Then place of residence. Where is the boy living? Where is the girl living? Now qualities needed in a partner. Do you want the person from the same profession? Do you want a housewife? Or do you want someone to be doing a part-time job, or you want a sweet nature, or someone who is willing to adjust in the joint family? There are many things which you can write. And then email address, phone number, and also sometimes people do not want to be bothered by so many mails and people calling them up unnecessarily. So they also keep this as a the box number of the time of any newspaper where any queries related to the alliance is sent to this box number, and whoever has given the ad can get all the queries from this box number which is being given in the ad. So now let's look at the example. Write an advertisement for a matrimonial column of the Times of India for a suitable match for a tall, fair, handsome, kayast boy, NIT pass out, that is National Institute of Designing, working in a famous fashion house with six figures monthly salary. Cast no bar, give the contact phone number as this and email address as this. Now, so since the boy is giving the ad, so he wants a bride. So you are writing the heading as bride wanted. Now bride, we are starting with bride wanted or wanted bride, anything you can write. Bride wanted for Kayas, Hindu boy, 180 centimeter, this much the age, and this is his educational qualification, this is his professional placement, this is his salary, and then these are the qualities, that he's a teetotaler, he's non-vegetarian, caste no bar, and decent manners they want. What kind of girl they are looking for? Girl to be minimum of 170 centimeter, that he doesn't want a very short girl, and similar profession preferred. And so contact on this and this number and this and this hot email address with bio data and photo. So this is a way you can write the ad. So it's very common thing, you know, whenever we think of any marriage proposal or something, what do we look for? We always look for how much the person is earning and how does he look like, how tall, how fat, or what is his education. So that is the same thing, whatever as a natural human being you think of, the same thing is being written in the advertisement also. Now let's look at the next one. So this says that the first one was the bride wanted and this is the bridegroom wanted. So this ad is being given by a girl. So you are Sukriti, 22, and BTech, working in a famous IT company in Gurgaon. Draft a matrimonial advertisement looking for a suitable boy for her. Give the detail, address, this. They are giving the box number. The contact number, direct contact number is not being given. So now the bridegroom wanted. Bridegroom wanted for Punjabi, sweet looking pair, 22 years, 155 centimeter, DPS pass out, IT professional girl in Gurgaon. Cast no bar, early and decent man. I have tried to keep the same as a boy. See height, age, from and then like what the person is doing, and that the boy was Kaya, she is Punjabi, okay, and then he was a teetotaler, and then she is sweet looking and fair. And then he also had written decent marriage. You also have written here decent marriage. Caste no bar was there also. Caste no bar is here also. But don't try to make it different every time. If you want to get the full marks, stick to one kind of the method and try to write that. Doesn't matter. The teacher has to just see whether the things which are required are there or not there. And depending upon that, the full marks will be given. So boy with fine educational background. So what is the requirement? IIT or IIM? And that boy had written he is teetotaler, so their teetotaler is preferred. And now they are giving the contact number as a box number. So this is it. It's so easy. It's something which can be written very easily. Just you need to go through the formats and the value points, and there's nothing which can stop you from scoring full marks. Come on, best of luck children. Do well in your exams.